Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are at the halftime break here. Richmond versus Northcote Tigers at home at Birkenhead War Memorial. And on the park there at the moment, a couple of the young ones just having a wee bit of fun as they're running around between the halftime break. And at the halftime score, Tigers lead 16 to the visitors, Richmond Bulldogs 10. Good to see the next generation of the Tigers coming through the grades here. And always a pleasure over here at Birkenhead War Memorial as part of their gala day, as we see a nice little move here. This takes on the line. We'll look for a quick play of the ball. It's a play on. Yeah, 16 people in the tackle. There we go. And always good to see the young fellas helping out with the coaching as well. And this is what rugby league's all about. If you are looking to get your young one into the game of footy, get to the Auckland Rugby League website, aucklandleague.co.nz, and you can find a club closest to you. And the people at the Auckland Rugby League be more than happy to direct you in the right place to your local club. Big thank you to SAS Sporting Apparel, Steedon, the official ball here at the Auckland Rugby League, and of course Safety First Removals, major sponsors of our interview section. And look at the runaway we've got on here. Oh, great cover tackle. Yeah, going to get up and play the ball slowly off that one. And looking for a runner. So we'll go back 16 feet to come forward 10. Still going back with the bigger sidestep. Oh, nice little fend. As Corey Rosser joins us back into the commentary box, and the Tigers are coming out of the changing room now. Richmond back to the halfway line as the little fellas just playing on for the last few minutes of their match. And Corey, good to see the young ones out there on the park, mate.
Absolutely. You summed it up a couple of minutes ago. It's what rugby league is all about, and fantastic to see the kids out having a good time. Awesome crowd down here today, of course, part of the 111-year anniversary for the club, and lots going on. Fantastic to see lots of family out and enjoying the day.
Now I see our little spy has just been around the paddock. I'll hand the airwaves over to the illustrious TJ Ashford, and let's get the drop on what's going down.
Yeah, a little spy's been talking to his mate, I think, the whole half time, so I'll be fascinated by the insights.
It's about leaning on those people that you actually know. But look, listening to the halftime speeches as we get into the second half. Look, Richmond, obviously more of what I was talking about in the first half. They're just not controlling the speed of the ruck, and they feel that they need to control that area before they can win this game for this contest. So look, they're definitely going to be playing up the middle. That's their go-to. They feel that that's their strength, and they want to try and turn this Northcote Tigers side around with some good kicking game. So that's from Richmond. As for Northcote, they need to do more of the same. So they're just looking at controlling the speed of the ruck, and also controlling their speed of the ruck as well. So they want to make sure that they control their big men, because they've identified that as their threat, and they need to go work tirelessly to try and slow down that, play the ball a little bit better, and they feel that that could win them the game. But both teams are actually high in spirits, so it's going to be a tough contest for this final 40.
There you go. Thank you, TJ. Fantastic to get your thoughts on what's happening at halftime, and some of the teams are starting to become a little suspicious of your lurking around at halftime, and perhaps start talking in Morse code. But anyway, it's Northcote on the football now. And Northcote really with the handy but by no means comfortable advantage on the scoreboard. Mitchell Ryan and a little knock on in there. Nautai works the short to Kosi, taken down by Tapou and Xavier Rice. 40 out from the line now, Richmond looking to continue this momentum, which started at the back end of the second half. Lafayeli, the makeshift dummy half. Harrison Sutton, he really changed the game when he came on. As we see Annandale bounce out of one and run another 10 or 15 metres untouched. Lafayeli now positioning play out to the right. Nortai going to the line, stepping off, finding an offload. Good play from the veteran number 7. Lafayeli to Annandale. Annandale holding it up. Playing in Tofa Timoteo late at the line. And that is the last, so that caught everyone, including the commentator, by surprise. So handover ball, and the Northcote Tigers now with a chance to rock this out. By no means a disaster there for Richmond to get tackled on that part of the field and make Northcote now go 90-odd metres, as we see a good carry from Barner, and a penalty which follows.
Yeah, that was another thing that the coaching staff were mentioning in the Richmond huddle at halftime as well, Corey, was just the amount of penalties that they're giving away, and easy exit sets there for the Northcote Tigers. So they need to definitely tidy up that area if they want to get themselves back into this contest.
It's interesting watching Robbie McIntosh take these kicks for touch. He's kicking the long way across the field each time. That time he was sort of certainly well over to our side of the field, but chose to kick across, slipped, and was probably
actually
a bit lucky to find touch.
See a forward pass here. The wind's actually quite strong when you're okay on the pitch as well. And I will trust in Robbie McIntosh. He's got a rugby background, so he's got a decent kick on him. So
He does.
Yeah.
Well, that explains it.
Yeah. Easily found touch that time as well. So.
So ball handling the downfall of the Northcote Tigers so far in the second half. Two mistakes already off two uses of the football. So Lafayeli retrieves off the back. Kosi puts a fend on. Lafayeli to Tuitama. Smack bam in the middle of the park now. Richmond looking for try number 3 of this game. Chance to potentially draw even as Sutton has taken the ground. Lafayeli jumping out, having a run at them here. Casey Lafayeli comes very, very close as well. Annandale shifts it on. The Northcote lines up quick. Oh, they did well there. Last coming up now for Richmond. They switch the direction of play. Annandale kicks in behind. Cleaned up well, though, by Amoa Tully, who then does well to avoid the tackle of Vasu, taking him back into the end goal. Ethan Schomkel, he's taken some tough carries today as Ethan Schomkel. Kurihaku. Boy, a bit of a penalty a thon so far, isn't it? Knock-ons from Northcote. We've got back chat now, which will march them 10. It's handling errors that Northcote are struggling with, and Richmond, just penalties galore.
Yeah, that's tough to apply any pressure defensively through their ill-discipline. They definitely need to work on that for the rest of this second half. But again, Northcote are just letting themselves off the hook here as well and turning over some soft ball, and they need to try and get some decent field position and play down the other end of the field here to try and extend their lead as Northcote look to take a quick tap, get on with the job.
Mitchell Ryan, 35 out from the line now, the Tigers. Rice back to Halalilo. Halalilo again attracting plenty of defensive attention. McIntosh to Tupou, taken by opposite number Tuitama. Tackle still up their sleeve here, Northcote. 7 minutes into the second half. McIntosh goes down the short, stepping back in, pops an offload. It's loose and cleaned up by Northcote. Last coming up now, Rice launches one skyward. A tester on here. And, well, Borden eventually may have copped a bump along the way. Annandale jumps out of dummy half and makes the most of no marker. Pati Tupai, very strong through the first 40, the Richmond custodian. Nortai. Late offload, the tackle's complete. Nortai kicks across the body. Finds grass as well. Bounce up nicely for Shonkel, who brings the football back, and the Richmond chase is good as well. We're going to go to TJ in a moment for some updates from around the grounds and some scores from halftime as Northcote continue to work this ball forward. The key here for Richmond will be no penalties. They've given away a penalty on every defensive set so far to Monty Cook, challenging that line. Poor pass from dummy half. Rice has to go low to retrieve. Tackle still up their sleeve here, Northcote. Tomoti Cook kicks up over the top, but it's going to find Leanga Mini on the full. And the Richmond number two will bring it back. TJ, what's happening elsewhere in Auckland?
Yeah, Koza, we've got a couple scores to update you with, and we'll start with the contest at Bert Hennam Park. Otahu leading that contest 22 points to 10. Over Bay Roskill, and I can confirm Marist Saints currently have their hand on the Rooster, currently leading that contest out there at Harold Moody, 8 points to four over Glenora, so that's a big one. The other two games that I've got at the moment is Papakura Seagulls in a tight battle at Tarako Park versus Pakuranga, winning 14 points to eight, and the Hibiscus Coast are trailing to the Manukau Magpies, 18 points to six as well.
Excellent. So Marist right now in a strong position to challenge for the Roop Rooster. First time anyone's taken it off Glenora this year, if it was the case. Lafayeli, they play down the left now, Henry. Annandale. Sioninahi. Nortai kicks across. And Watson, well, it was messy. Shomkul picks it up. Tell you what, Shonkel almost stepped his way back into the in-goal area there. Was lucky to get out of there. Big work on now for Northcote. Talakai, well, went a long way sideways, not a long way forward. Harrison Sutton, good contact. They've gone only a metre or so forward so far, Northcote, as they approach the back end of the set. So only just now getting outside of the 10, and this will be the last tackle. So Rice to McIntosh, and it's a very good kick. Well, Northcote, who were in a fair bit of trouble there again, Robbie McIntosh, TJ, you touched on it earlier, his kicking game, it's been superb all day.
Yeah, pity they're not playing NRL rules out there today as well. Corey, that was a 20-40 there, so. But again, you know, they're very lucky that McIntosh kicked them out of trouble there. They needed to get some bigger bodies behind the ball early and get some tough carries in there, and their back five just didn't help them get out of the exit zone there. And I just feel that Richmond, they've tidied up the penalty count in the last couple of minutes, and they're just slowly turning the screws here on Northcote. And if they can continue doing that, I definitely feel that they can take the lead in this contest here at Birkenhead War Memorial.
It's Annandale to pack down. Here's Liang Amini. Matty Tuitama. Right on halfway. Nahi, lovely offload late at the line. Brings in Alex Kalilupou. Lafaeli. Chance on here. Massive contact from Amoa Tuli. That'll get a play on the replay. Boy, oh boy. See if we can catch a look at that on our CTES film crew. It's looking likely for a second here as Alex Kalilupou broke free. But I'll tell you what, Amoa Tuli, TJ, did not miss on this occasion.
Nah, that was a massive shot. Waiki went deep into the line there and just gave Tuli enough time to come up and put that shot on. But I want to give a bit of credit there to Pati Tupai as well, eh? Because after a shot like that, he just bounced straight back to his feet there. And he's now back into the attacking line here to receive the ball. And no doubt he'll be taking a carry shortly.
So Nautai grabbing across field, running towards Talakai. Michael McKinnon. Nahi. Sione Nahi. Ball hit loose. Was there multiple players in that tackle? Play on, says referee Newton. So Northcote rise to the occasion. And now get a fresh set of six to work with. And we got a little knock on in there. We have. So ball turns over again. Northcote, the handling in the second half in particular, near non-existent in terms of completed sets. So scrum to pack down. It's going to be a Richmond feed. 54 and a half gone. You're joining us for round five of the Crown Lift Trucks Fox Championship. It is the North City Reinforced Limited Northcote Tigers who lead this one 16-10 right now over the LJ Hooker Bulldogs. Time off, and I think we've got a player down commanding a little bit of attention. And perhaps while we wait for the game to resume, guys, 111 years of Northcote Tigers football. I want to hear who your all-time favourite Tiger is. I'm going to start things off with one maybe a little left of field. I'm going to go with Alex Glenn. 280-odd NRL games, represented both the Kiwis and Cook Islands, a star at under-20 level, and remains a real big contributor at NRL level.
I'm going to go before NRL existed, probably back to the New South Wales Rugby League, but no, for my top of the picks, started at Northcote, finished at Northcote, Twins, Northcote hard, the Foo Boys.
There you go, and as Matty Tuitama gets us back underway, we'll wait to go to TJ for his pick. Penalty, and it's going to go the way of Northcote. Boy, we haven't kept a penalty count today. I'd love to see it. We'll be running out of paper, I'd say. So Northcote 2, kick for touch. And TJ Ashford, your all-time great Northcote Tiger from 111 years.
Yeah, man, I can't go past the whiz, eh? Gary Freeman's probably my favourite from Northcote. And as a young player, someone I definitely looked up to as well. And one thing I probably got from him was a bit of his mouth on the field. He's a bit lippy. Excuse Troy Hardy off in the cheap seats there. But yeah, he's a good player, was the Wiz, and he's very crafty at his job as well. But he's definitely my favourite Northcote player.
They have had some wonderful talent come through this club and play for this club, and of course even current day Jackson Topany at the Canterbury Bulldogs. Moving play now back through the middle of the park. This is Sione Talilotu. Northcote with a spring in the step. Looking to extend this to a two-score advantage. Xavier Rice going right to the line, then bringing in Halalilo. Halalilo popping an offload. The ball is spilt, though. And just as Northcote is starting to generate some momentum, it breaks down.
Yeah, Corey, it's good to see Xavier Rice out there as well. We got the luxury of obviously watching off camera, but just his work off the ball communication-wise and organisation around the attacking sets, and again, working tirelessly on defence as well. So it's good to see him back out there in Northcote colours this year.
Xavier Rice spent time over in Europe. Was with London Scholars for a little while there. Contact from Richmond. Carly Lupol leading the charge there for the Bulldogs. This game now starting to get a little bit of spice about it. Rice, oh, collected high. So Rice down, receiving some medical attention.
Just as we get back into the action as well, Corey, Marist Saints have extended their lead out in Harold Moody, 14 points to 4. So they're trying to keep themselves back in this contest here for that top four chase, but Otahu still currently leading Bay Ross School 22 points to 10 as well. So that puts a little bit of a dampener on that, but Marist is still have the opportunity to get the Root Rooster in their hand for 2021 as well.
Yeah, well, if you're not going to make the playoffs, and Marist are still on the chase for that, the next best thing you can do is take the Root Rooster into the off-season. Halalilo. Fire to McIntosh. Here's Tapau off the left leg again. Tapau back through the middle of the park. There's cover coming across, and in the end, the slippery surface is what gets them. Stephen Tapau, again, another outstanding game from this Northcote forward. The Tigers now rucking it up with Halalilo. Last coming up. About 3 metres to travel. Halalilo might have picked up a knock here. Tamoti Cook stabs a kick through. It's wayward. And we'll go back out to the 22. Get back underway. Well, TJ, the Northcote Tigers, when they actually complete sets, are looking nice and energetic. I think they've only completed 2 in the whole second half so far. But yeah, look, they look like getting something going.
Yeah, it's no surprises as well. Every time that they've completed their sets, they've finished at the right end of the field, Corey. And I was talking at halftime to injured Northcote captain as well, Eddie Fungota. And one of the things that he was talking about is just the ball control as well. That's something that's they're losing at the moment, so they need to definitely fix that up in the next couple of weeks, in particular for today's clash as well, because if they can do that, I have a feeling they'll put a few more points on the board against this Richmond Bulldogs pack.
Cossey, brilliant run. Still going as Ben Cossey, told to play the ball this time. Lafayeli. He's been good today, Casey Lafayeli, playing both lock and dummy half. Taylor Daniels looking like getting his boarding pass back onto the field and back play. Annandale short at the line and brung in Tofa Timotea, who promoted the ball as well. The young and mini, this is Wesley. It's messy from Richmond. It's more than messy. It's a knock on. So on the hour mark, It has been a rather forgettable, I should say, second half so far. A lot of penalties, a lot of errors. No points so far. Big hello to our good mate Devesh Kumar at Waterview Laundromat as well. His logo proudly spotted there on the back of the Richmond jerseys. So as it stands, not knowing what's happening between Point Chevalier and Howick, Otahu potentially jumping a couple more points clear in that race for fourth position. And potentially the Root Rooster heading to Murray Halberg Park as we see Talakai unleashed down the left-hand side. Cover coming across in the shape of Tupai, who goes up high and pulls off a stunning try-saving tackle. Wow! Don't worry about what happened afterwards. Albert Talakai is one of the most powerful centres in the competition. And Ropati Tupai, look at this on the replay. He's streaking clear here. Managed to pull the ball free. And I think we'll get a Northcote ball at the end of all this.
Yeah, that's probably one thing that Albert can look to improve on over the next couple of years as well. I know he's young and coming through our under-20 system as well at the start of the year, but he's his strength is in his running game. It's the ball playing as well. It's the passing ability. He had a player on the inside there unmarked as well. Could have looked to shape him up for a little bit more attacking options to finish off under the post there. But again, nice strong run and even better tackle there by Pati Tupai.
So scrum fed by McIntosh. Here's Daniels. Barner. Bit of experience on for the final quarter here for Northcote. Fire to Halalilo. Richmond scrambled beautifully though to close that down. Shift play back towards the middle of the park. McIntosh taking the ground. Shomkul, yeah, I thought there may have been a little bit extra in the tackle there. Surely the two has to be an option here. You're six in front. Let's wait to see what call comes. And yeah, that is it. Jordan Tiaho racing on with the two fingers raised. So a chance to make this an 8-point ball game.
Interesting to hear ex-Point Chevalier player Troy Hardy. Just listening to him off air, he was saying I would have taken the quick tap there and finished my set to take a field goal, he reckons. So,
yeah, lovely bloke Troy Hardy, but not much of a team player at times. Perhaps looking to inflate the personal stats. So kick to come from Watson. It's not in the best part of the field in terms of surface, but no mistake. Stretch it out to 8. North City Reinforcing Limited, Northcote Tigers 18. LJ Hooker, Richmond Bulldogs 10. With about 16 to play here at Birkenhead War Memorial Park.
Troy Hardy still going on about his 1 point. Classic Troy Hardy. Big 15 minutes coming up here for Northcote. Corey, and it starts by this attacking set here. They need to complete the set, kick down deep to a corner here and try and turn up on their defense. So interesting to see how this next 15 minutes plays out.
Barner. How important will the likes of Barner and Daniels be as this final quarter approaches? Speaking of Daniels, there he is on the ball. Faye with a good run out of dummy half. Good ruck recognition today. Been a strong contributor for Jeff Morton's side. Halalilo. Last coming up now for the Tigers. To Moti Cook. Launches one skyward. Tupai under it, but drops it. Well, you've got to feel a little bit for Rapati Tupai there. That's a ball you've got to make a play at, but it was certainly coming down with a fair bit of gusto. So another set coming up now for the Northcote Tigers. Another chance to apply some more pressure.
Just while we got the break with the scrum as well, Corey Harold, Moody Park, all locked up, 14 points all. Ooh. Tough contest out there out west. So we see Marist Saints. See Marist Saints trying to get that root rooster off the Bears after having it pretty much all of 2021.
Yeah, took it off Mount Albert in what must have been round two from memory, and have held it ever since. I think they have a defence coming up if they do hold it against Point Chevalier, which will be interesting in a couple of weeks' time, next week. So Northcote on the footy. McIntosh, he's been excellent today, as has this man, Shomkul. Weaving his way through for a couple of extra metres. Fire to Rice. To Powell. Faye links with his half. Not much doing so far for Northcote on this set. Rice dribbles a kick in behind. David Barner! The big man's in. Newton points to the spot. Barner celebrates. And Northcote take another step towards victory here against Richmond. Take a look now on the Crown Lift Trucks replay.
Yeah, I think the ball's taken a bit of deflection here, and we'll see if he's picked it up. No, great hands by the big front rower. David Barner, he'll be watching that on repeat. Troy Hardy, your numbers will go up the roof thanks to David Barner scoring that four-pointer today. But again, I want to put a shout-out there to Xavier Rice as well. Corey, you can see him before he got the ball there, just off ball, he's organising the ruck and making sure players are knowing what they're doing off the ball as well. So he's played outstanding today. I'm pretty sure we'll see him on Kiwi League Central Team of the Week as well.
There we go. Of course, our select is a top secret, but we do value TJ's opinion, so send that through to the CEO. Troy Hardy's still talking about a drop goal. So Watson to attempt the conversion from in front. Kick's good. 14 the gap, 12 to play. So watch for the short kickoff. Annandale drills it low instead. Northcote moving the ball early. Goes to Daniels. Fire to Barner. Hey, McIntosh turns back inside. Five short of halfway now, Northcote. The set after points to Monty Cook. Directing Daniels back towards the middle. He'll be taken down right on halfway. Kick's going to be important here for Northcote, and Daniels has come up with an error.
They needed to get to their kick there too, Corey, because that was the last play. It'll be a changeover there as well. So that was a big play by an experienced player, Taylor Daniels. He needed to pick the ball off the ground before he tried to get up there. And Northcote need a muscle. Oh, it was a knock on. There you go. Return serve.
It's the game that keeps on giving in terms of knock-ons. So Rice retrieves off the back of the scrum. You would think points here would just about finish the game off for the Tigers. Morgan to Monty Cook. Albert Talakai is calling for the ball out on the left-hand wing. Xavier Rice charging towards the post. Halalilo is going to become the makeshift dummy half. McIntosh slipped in the mud for a second there. Pops an offload. Halalilo. Very good defense from Richmond. Dylan Vail onto the field as well. Kick goes in behind. It's scooped up by Ropati Tupai. Don't want to give that man a little opportunity for a half break. Harrison Sutton. Henry getting on the outside, pops an offload. Leanga Mini now into space. Good covering tackle though from, I think, Corey Haku. Confusion as to what happened down on the ground. Leanga Mini's down injured. Kick goes in behind. McIntosh does well to get down low and retrieve. And now we'll have time off. There's players down everywhere. Leanga Mini down on the left wing. Talakai and McIntosh have got cramp. And Kameli Vasu's just been helpful and assisting there. Good sportsmanship. Let's go back to Murray Halberg Park in a moment, or I should say Harold Moody Park, and get an update on the Root Rooster Challenge.
Yeah, Glenora have clawed their way back there and currently leading that contest 22 points to 14 at Harold Moody. And Bay Roskill Vikings has also closed that gap against Otahu, currently trailing them by 4 points, 22 points to 18. Now, tight contest back out of Tarako. They've managed to bring that one back in, and those scores are locked there between Pakuranga and Papakura, 14 points all. And Manukau Magpies currently leading 28 points to 12 as well. So those are all the updates from around the ground so far.
So as it stands, Manukau with the chance to hit back even with Richmond at the top. Northcote would take a step towards the top four, but depending what happens between Pakuranga and Papakura. Daniels pops the ball out the back.
Oh,
Northcote getting to a kick. Goes in behind. Henry picks up and links with fullback.
Outstanding effort by number 14 for Northcote as well, to Corey Nicholas Halililo, yep. Normally a back rower, and with the amount of injuries, especially through their captain Eddie Fingota, he's played in the middle of the field today, and he's been good, big minutes, tough carries, and he's struggling there at the moment, but he's pushing through for his side, so well done to Nicholas.
Yeah, it's a great shout, TJ. He's had a very, very good game. Nautai. Got Harrison on his shoulder, they kick him behind, and Shomkul cleans up. Halililo, you can see him there struggling with cramp. That's DePaul.
Still struggling as we see David Barner go back behind the ruck, but that's the last tackle there, and they still haven't got over the 40 yet. I don't think Dylan's known. That's a tough decision by Dylan as well. Hopefully that doesn't come back to cost them. They needed to get to their kick there as well, did Northcote.
Yeah, Dylan Vale's in a bad way here as well. So Dylan's going to get some attention here. That might be the end of his game for today. Yeah, he's not looking too healthy at all, so we wait. Maybe the ribs, actually. See the trainer there paying a bit of attention to him. So as it stands in this competition, Monaco are going to draw back even with Richmond at the top. Northcote will get the jump on either Papakura or Pakaranga. And in the first division, the Glenora Bears, what a second half effort that is. They're up 26-14 now after trailing, was it 14-4 at one point there, TJ? They're back in the contest, and Otahuhu still holding on against Bay Roskill. They'll be nervous in that game as well, because Bay Roskill have got the ability to pile on points quickly. So here's Otis Hall.
It's an important game for Otahuhu as well, Corey. They win this week and get one win next week. It doesn't matter about Howick's results then. Destiny's in their own hands, so it's important that they snag the wins while they can in the next couple of weeks.
Lafaeli. Vasu. Nautai. Short to Harrison Sutton. Tuitama going low. Ball comes loose. That's probably going to be the game. Shomkul cleans up. And this set will probably be one of the slowest you've ever seen. To life with a little energetic carry there. 30 off their own line. It's Rice. Halililo again, center of it, and comes up with a little error in the play of the ball there. Well, TJ, we've already got one suggestion for Team of the Week from you. Who else is impressed today and could be in line for honours?
Yeah, I like the look of Nick Kalililo as well. And also think Ethan Shumko at the back for Northcote as well. He's been very, very good. For Richmond, Sione Nahi started well, but I haven't seen much of him in this back end of this game. But Pati Tupai, their fullback, has probably been a standout for me as well. He's been pretty good with his carries. And also, I believe it might have been the locker. Is that the captain, Casey Lafayette?
Yeah, indeed.
He's been pretty decent as well. So a couple recommendations for some teams of the week there. But again, there's plenty of other footy to be played around the ground. So definitely don't know what's been happening out there at the moment.
Siren goes in the background. Nortai to Kossi. It's backhand field. They kick. The game's over. The Northcote Tigers with a huge victory as they search for a top four finish. And it ends here at Birkenhead War Memorial Park. North City Reinforcing Limited, Northcote Tigers 24. LJ Hooker, Richmond Bulldogs 10. Short break before we go pitch side for the safety first removals, captain's interviews. Joining me now, Morgan Tamoti Cook, the captain of the Northcote Tigers. As I have the Tiger players in the background. Morgan, massive win for the club.
It was. We know coming into this game, they're top of the table. They've been, you know, after we got dropped to that middle group, they've been sort of the top team as well. Them, Te Aritu, Manukau as well, actually. And we fell off with a few other games. Manukau, Te Aritu put a tally on us as well, but it was good to come out here and play a good side and get the dub.
Say a fair bit about the club, the I guess resilience you've shown over the last few weeks to put a performance like this one.
Oh, it was, and we knew for the club day as well. Actually, one of our boys, Taylor Bear, shout out to Taylor, it's his 100th game as well. So a lot on the line, a lot to play for as well. We are proud Tigers as well, so again, happy to get the dub.
Down a few middles today, guys like Nicholas Halililo really stood up. A few words on your four pick.
Oh, Lassie's been huge for us this whole season, a standout. As well as Stevie on the edge, he moved from 13 to the edge as well. But again, missing guys like Ed, he did his ankle last week. And Big Robbie as well, he done his ankle last week as well. So for David as well, stepping up more minutes for him. Now they really laid a good platform for us.
Morgan, congratulations. The fight for a top four spot continues. All the very best for the next few weeks.
More games, yeah. Thank you very much.
Joining me now, Casey from the Richmond Bulldogs. Well, Casey, it's been a good run of the championship so far, but where did it fall short today, mate?
I think the boys just probably came in and expected an easy game. But Northcote, you know, they really wanted a win. They needed a win today, and you could see it in their performance. They wanted it more than us today.
A bit of a timely wake-up call if you needed one as we head into the playoffs?
Yeah, exactly, mate. You're spot on. You know, there's no easy games in rugby league, as you know, so we got to make sure we come focused week in, week out, and
Awesome. Casey, thanks for joining us. All the best for the next couple of weeks.
Yes, thank you very much. Thank you.
That concludes our coverage here from Birkenhead War Memorial Park. The Northcote Tigers too good today against Richmond. We are back in action next week. AucklandLeague.co.nz for all of the details. We'll see you then.